Well, this is my first solo show here in Cincinnati, and it's pretty much a compilation of a lot of different mediums and styles of art that I've been involved in the last several years, from paintings, abstracts, to direct observational pieces, sculptures in bronze, and some animations. Opening night was amazing. It was wall-to-wall people for the entire night of the show. Lots of friends and family, lots of new friends since I've moved back, so that was really nice. We had a jazz quartet from the School of Creative and Performing Arts, which just filled the place beautifully with this really warm jazz sound. And the place was full of love, and it was just great. I started in the fine arts in my late 40s, about 2008, when I really delved into taking some sculpture classes and painting classes. And I got my first studio in about 2010. So it feels like it's a relatively new journey for me, but it's been going on for about 12 years. Did my first bronze in 2013, and in a way I've gone. So it's been a lot of fun. I'm inspired by a lot of different people. As a graphic designer, I grew up really admiring people like Milton Glaser and Paul Rand, and moved into looking at a lot of illustrators' works over the years. And then as I became more aware of artists, I became a real fan of Picasso and Matisse. And then that evolved when Keith Haring came along in the 80s, who was a big influence for myself and a lot of designers I worked with, and I really admired his style. And over the years, it's evolved into a lot of different artists that I follow, including this guy on the West Coast named Craig Frazier, whose work is very graphical, but has a great sense of humor, and he's translated that into animations as well. I've been following him for years and really like his work. I'm really excited to share a particular body of work that I've been working on for the last 5 or 6 years. It's a family of sculptures and now paintings and animations featuring a character I call the Twood. It rhymes with mood. And they've been a great teacher of mine to me over the past several years, helping me understand some things about myself and really questioning the duality of inter and intrapersonalities and relationships. I have a lot of young people say, gosh, I really wish I had a studio. And I was thinking before I had a studio. So it will happen, it can happen. And my main advice is to make sure you just be yourself. Trust yourself, dance your own dance, sing your own song. Be who you are, but don't try to be somebody else. Put in the work and time, and don't be afraid to fail miserably at times.